Alright, you guys, just finished my fifth exercise there with about 15 seconds left on my watch. Here's what I did. The sequence was really straightforward, you guys. Five exercise complex. Okay, started with my heaviest load going to a second load, third load, lightest load for the fourth exercise, and then I finished with something body weight. Okay, let me explain to you what I did. Started with one kettlebell, guys, goblet squats and double arm swings. I've shown you this in other videos. Goblet squat, really simple, you guys. Come in with our set, solid stance. I like to keep those feet just outside my hips. Goblet position's right here with one kettlebell, okay? Forcing us to keep our trunk upright. Okay, drop the hips back and down. Okay, when we squat, remember, we maintain that heel contact. Drop it back and down. Stay nice and upright, drive through. We had 8 goblet squats, right into 8 double arm swings. Where the arms are straight, we're using that partial squat to drive the kettlebell up to about chest height in a continuous and ballistic, explosive fashion. We had 8 of those. And that's the theme for today. It's a 16 rep count for all of our exercises. What I was timing were 45 second intervals. You've got 45 seconds to get your 16 reps, find whatever rest you have left until that beat, and then get on it again, okay? So I got my 16 at that next fresh beat. I was over here with my second load. You guys, I got a single swing, which is exactly like our double arm swing, except it's with one arm. So we are rocking back with a straight arm, whipping that bell back. We drive forward, trade at the chest. So I grab for my left here, let that left arm go down, and drive and repeat. I had 8 total swings, 4 on each arm, right into upright rows, strict upright rows. Both hands here, pulling elbows high, elbows above the wrist, okay? Notice with these, you guys, I didn't set down the kettlebell. That's a goal. No set down with the kettlebell for these. Transition, hold that kettlebell, do not set it down. Make that a goal. 8 total swings, single. 8 total upright rows. I went here to my third load, you guys, and I was doing some unilateral work, rocking that single arm goblet position that we've talked about, and I got 4 squats with a kettlebell on my right side and stayed on that right side with that theme and went into a right side, so same side stance, split squat for 4. So 4 squats, 4 split squats, that's 8. Centered up again, switched hands, my left arm now in that single arm goblet with the kettlebell, dropped it down, okay? Perfect squat form. I like to bring my arm out, okay? And see that everything in the trunk stays in line, that I'm not twisting, that I'm not imbalanced, okay? In line, balanced, solid, stable trunk. And then I just put right into my 4 split squats on the left side now, same side. So my kettlebell's on the left and my left leg is doing the work. That's our same side idea. 4 and 4, 16 total. Almost got swallowed up there, if you notice. Real close to that 45 second mark, so I went pretty much right into my final exercise, which was, we call them deadlift rows, you guys. Set that stance, get in our good bent row stance. Talked about this, a lot of people mess this up. We want those hips back, knees bent, trunk stable, neutral alignment, nice and solid through the trunk. We do not move from this position with the deadlift rows or any bent rows. We shouldn't be doing this, okay? We're locked in position, and that deadlift row comes from a dead weight position. We row, okay, elbows back, get the shoulder blades back, squeeze back there, wrist to rib, drop it down. That kettlebell should touch every time. I had 8 on the right, and then I was gonna get 8 on the left, okay? Square stance, rowing, 8 and 8, that's our 16 count. I finished with 30 seconds out of the 45 doing my forward knee drivers, okay? 30 seconds, giving me the last 15 seconds to get back to that starting point. You guys, what you see right there, that 5 exercise complex, is 1 round. You've got 3 to get, okay? 3 rounds to get. But in total, okay, these 4 exercises, you're at 3 minutes. You get here, 3.5 minutes of work. You go to that 3 minute, 45 second mark. String those together, guys. You're working for less than 12 minutes by the time you get done with this complex. Fast, intense, get through 3 rounds, try to not set the kettlebell down, and we're on to our next circuit. Yeah. guys. Circuit two, same idea. Five exercise complex. Each exercise gets a 16 count rep assignment, okay, for our loaded ones. Finishing with a bodyweight exercise. All of those work intervals are 45 seconds long, meaning you get that rep assignment within that 45 seconds. The more power you elicit, the higher your work rate with strict form, the more rest you're gonna get before that next fresh interval. That's how that works. That's why we time it, you guys. Keep your work rate high with strict technique and strict form, maximize your power output, and move on to the next block, okay? Very minimal rest when it's all said and done. But even at this point, the seconds matter. Okay, let me break down what we did in the five exercise complex. Started out, you guys, right here with my kettlebell. Went a little lighter with a little fancier variation of my swing. Okay, what I did is combined a crazy eight. I've shown you a crazy eight in the previous video. Crazy eight is basically when we pass that kettlebell in our nice bent row stance through our legs here and pass it in front, hand it back behind, pass it, and so on and so forth. Makes that nice eight around our lower leg. What I did was threw one part of that crazy eight through, grabbed it here, and really have to, I popped my hips through for a single arm swing coming outside the body, okay? Right out of that swing, I'm down into my crazy eight, okay? Other side, transferring it and extending through powerfully to get that swing coming outside of my body. Nothing changes in terms of our swing mechanics from the standpoint that we have our feet flat, heels in contact with the ground. We're getting a lot of hip flexion, okay? Nice solid trunk, a little bit more rotation action here, but really have to powerfully extend the hips through to get that bell coming from behind us now and out in front of our body and transfer through. I suggest you go light until you get the pattern down, and once you get that rhythm going, you can really kind of load a little heavier and feel what's firing and how that is different from our traditional swings. I had 16 total swings there. That would be 8 each arm. Transitioned you guys into what we call a hammer throw. Same kind of idea as our kettlebell swing there, but with a dumbbell, narrowing my stance, you guys, about hip width, getting that dumbbell to come from outside of my body. So I load it with a little rotation and a bend that's offset, okay? Offset, and I still extend through like I'm swinging, and I just tap it. Tap it in the middle of my body, I reload and drive. So my hammer throw coming from that offset loading, a little rotation, but a full extension through, a lot like we do with the crazy eight swing, okay? I went eight on my right and eight on my left, you guys, same thing. Loading it down here, so dropping that down and just firing the hips through enough to pop and center and tap, okay? Load and tap, being right here in the midline, still coming about chest height. That's our hammer throw, guys. Stuff that's a little bit more fancy, so to speak, takes a little bit more coordination, but fun stuff once you can master it. So load appropriately, load a little bit lighter, get the technique and form, and have some fun with those. Then we kept it really straightforward. I went from those two lighter, real speed-based, explosive-based exercises to an alternating single-arm deadlift. One thing you guys will notice when you look at the video, that dumbbell is coming from between my feet, okay? I do not wanna have to reach out here for my dumbbell when I deadlift, okay? I'm not pulling from here. That deadlift is coming from in between my feet, and I am locked in. I have to flex my hips and bend my knees to get myself in this position. We don't want a deadlift from this position. Bend the knees, get yourself in this position with a stable trunk, neutral spine alignment, lock in those lats, nice strong grip, and then we drive up and through, full extension. A lot of times I see people fall just short of the extension and they come back down. Get those hips fully extended. We have to get that every time we squat, deadlift, swing, all that stuff, all that athletic performance-based type of training and those types of movements, we have to get that full extension, you guys. So we set it down after one deadlift, we trade at the bottom, okay? We never come up without weight. Trade at the bottom, grab it with the opposite arm, same strict form, and drive. You shouldn't feel too much major rotation or twisting or offset loading. That trunk should stay in line, strong pull, trading at the bottom. We had 16 total alternating deadlifts, okay? So 16 total pulls, 8 each arm. I finished down here, you guys, on my floor press, okay? So with my floor press, really simple, just like it sounds, we're down on the ground, on the floor, okay? I like to bend my knees, recommend you bend your knees, get stable here, we're nice and stable on the ground. I did a piston variation, you guys had a pronated grip, which means my palms are out. Piston means I start with my elbows fully extended, and I'm gonna move one arm independently while the other arm stays extended, and drive up and meet at the top, and alternate, and meet at the top. This is my piston variation, and I did 8 each arm for 16 total presses. Every time on the floor press, my upper arm touches the floor, and I fully extend through to meet right at the midline of my body. Then alternate, touch that floor. That's why we call it a floor press. Coming from the floor, driving up, meeting at the midline, you guys. So nice, strong contractions, full extension, full range of motion, nice, controlled, powerful movements. The last thing I did, I went down for just another knee driver variation. That's our twisting driver. Getting in that push-up hold position, and then setting my stance, and then getting my right knee to start was over to my left elbow, okay? Back and switch, left knee to right elbow, boom. Boom, once you get comfortable is when you can add that speed and switch with more speed, okay? Being precise to get that knee across the midline and to the opposite elbow and then switching. That was for 30 seconds. You find the last 15 seconds of rest and you're back on that exercise one. You guys, that was circuit 2, 5 exercise complex. You've got what you saw was one round of that circuit. You would have 3 rounds to do nonstop, okay? Stay strong, you guys. Let's keep getting it. Thank you. Ah. Circuit three, you guys. Whew. Ah, a little upper body blast right there to finish. Same type of theme as the first two circuits that we saw together. Five exercises, 45 second work intervals to meet your assigned reps. That's for the loaded exercises. Waiting for that next fresh beep, that next fresh interval before starting the next exercise in the sequence. Finishing with our cardio-based knee drivers to keep the heart rate up, keep things flowing. What you saw right there, once again, round one round of three that we had to get. Okay, let me walk you through what I just did, you guys. Two dumbbells on the ground. Our first exercise was a push-up hold alternating dumbbell row. So when I say push-up hold, all I mean is we are in a push-up hold position. Okay, here is my push-up hold position right here. Back straight, okay? Everything in line in this push-up hold position. Shoulders to my hips, all the way down to my ankles, okay? I'm not sagging and I'm not hyped up, okay? What you can do when you row is widen your base a little bit if you need to, okay? And when we row, one arm stays down and we're gonna drive that other row right to our rib. Elbow back. Guys, a little rotation is not a bad thing here. Okay, we do not have to stay perfectly stripped. I like to get my athletes and myself, people in here training under my guidance, with a little rotation to really feel and facilitate that retraction. Okay, stabilize here, solid arm, row, set it down, and repeat. Okay? That rotation is not a bad thing when we're talking about it facilitating that retraction and that nice squeeze that we want. Elbows back, wrist to that rib area. We're putting it up and down for 16 total rows, 80 charms. Same thing, that's been the theme. That 16 count, right, has been the theme today. Within 45 seconds, 16 movements before we move on to the next. So 16 total rows there. I went back to back with a total body rowing variation to arguably a little bit more isolation, but still, total body nonetheless. We've got to lock our core and our bodies into a stable position, fall down with these TRX bands into a nice, stable, straight body position. My arms are fully extended at the top of each rep, no matter what, sorry, the bottom, and I'm gonna pull wrist to ribs like I always do. Chest pulling through, elbows back, shoulder blades back. I get a full stretch every time, you guys. Sometimes I see people get here and they're rowing in that range of motion. We need those elbows fully extended to stretch everything that we want to contract when we pull, okay? Do not lose that straight body alignment. Don't dip the hips. Don't drive them through and hyperextend. Imagine yourself as a piece of iron right there. Lock yourself into that stable position. And then we let the arms do the rest, okay? We let that nice pulling, horizontal pulling movement take us up and down. We have a 16 count body weight right here. Now I'm going to sort of a chest, two exercise sort of chest complex within that sequence here. I went down for my floor press, you guys, like we saw in that second circuit, but all I was doing was adding a glute bridge. So here is our decline, our sort of decline floor press variation, where I still am starting extended, I went with the piston variation, pronated grip, palms forward, and then you guys, I just drove my hips up, solid bridge position. Do not lose this position, just like with our rows, and anything else where we need to lock in a stable trunk to get into position, lock it in, stabilize, and then let everything else come from what we're focusing on in terms of the movement. This is our bench right here. This is our bench position. We make our own benches, and then we make that press happen. Piston, meeting at the top, squeezing in the midline, that upper arm touches the floor, every time when I squeeze through. That's hard. Glute bridge, floor press. That's pronated grip piston variation there. And then guys, I went right into a narrow grip push-up for 16 reps total. The floor press, by the way, was 16 total, that's 80 charm. And all I did with my narrow, you guys, I made sure my hands were inside my shoulders. Okay, we've got shoulder width, we've got outside the shoulder width, okay, something a little bit more common or wide, and then our narrow comes somewhere inside the shoulders. We are still getting that full range of motion. You guys will notice my nose touches the floor, okay? I don't like to see people get that hyperextension in their neck and look up when they do the push-ups. I say save the strain on the neck. Keep your cervical spine nice and neutral when you do a push-up, okay? Nice and neutral. Get over here. C-spine nice and neutral, you guys, no matter what our hand position is, that spine should stay neutral, okay? And if I get low enough, which we do and we will, that nose can lightly touch, okay? Like I do a lot of the times, I'll just put a towel down there. You know, if you don't want to get your nose to a dirty floor, put a towel down there and make sure that that nose hits the towel and you drive through. Full extension, okay? Too many times I see the partial extension push-up. People get to about right here and they're dropping in that mid-range, that partial range. Full extension, a controlled extension, but full nonetheless, you guys. Full range of motion, feeling that chest. Once again, we're narrow inside the shoulders. I just finished with a outward knee driver variation, and like it describes, outside the elbow is our outward. We had our forward to start, our twisting came second, and then we went outward, okay? And once you get that rhythm is when you can pick up your speed and really make it something cardio based. So those five exercises, you guys, we saw a similar thing. Like I'd like to write these up. Pretty thematic across the board. Three circuits, five exercises each. We stuck with 16 total movements, 16 total reps in each of the exercises. We stayed on a timer, 45 second blocks, getting our reps, challenging ourselves with good loads, but loads that allow us to keep our technique strict and maintain perfect and strict form. And we just get on that exercise to exercise to exercise, finishing with our little cardio knee driver, getting right on our next round. We had three to do for each of those circuits, you guys. So, you know, like I like to say, we get to those points in these workouts. This was a quick one. Three rounds of each circuit will take you under 12 minutes to do. So with transition time, we're looking total for this workout, probably 45 minutes. We warm up a little bit before, 10, 15 minutes, get our body temperature up, prepare ourselves for this battle, and we're looking about an hour, you guys. Intense, short, maximizing our time, maximizing our effort, putting in here what we want to get out. And I say that, you guys, every time we hit those points where we're tired, we're feeling that pain, that discomfort, and you want to stop. Everything inside of you saying, stop, stop, you know, this is too much, is when we need to focus our energy, focus our efforts, and push past those points. Those are the points that define us. Those are the points that grow us. And what we put into those moments, guys, what we put into these sessions is exactly what we'll get out of them. Okay, don't come in here thinking we can go at half speed, you know, or half effort, and we're gonna get max results. Nothing like that works. Nothing works like that in life, and it especially doesn't work like that in the gym. So I challenge you to come in here, push yourself, teach yourself and show yourself, prove to yourself that what you put into something, you will get out. What you earn is what you're gonna get in here and in life. You've gotta earn it, you've gotta fight for it, you've gotta work for it. There is no other way, you guys. I challenge you to take on those lessons in the gym with me. Push yourselves. Let's go for it every time and come out of here stronger, better, prepared for whatever life is gonna throw at us, because we've solidified that belief in ourselves up here and through all of this, you guys. So I hope you like this video. Thanks for watching. I'm here for you guys, and I love what we're doing, man. This is our lifestyle, and we're gonna keep on going for as long as it takes. I'm Dr. Matt Minowaiva, helping you stay fit, helping you stay strong, mentally and physically. Good job, guys.